Today's 2 minutes that can change your life is a subject many of us want to avoid. The question is it okay to be angry? Many of us work very hard to stay in the flow and remain peaceful, and we often shy away from feeling or expressing anger. The Old Testament portrays God to be a God of vengeance and wrath many times, but in my studies, it appears that mankind was making God in their own image. The psalmist David said this in Psalms 143:8, "Let me hear your loving kindness in the morning, for I trust in you. Teach me the way in which I should walk, for to you I lift up my soul." But then we read in Romans 1:18, "For the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men, who by their unrighteousness suppress the truth." Right now, a lot of people are feeling anger over what seems to be a suppression of truth by others. So, is it okay to be angry? In the book, Ask and It Is Given, Abraham, a collective of souls who speak through Esther Hicks, show an emotional scale. The bottom is depression and apathy, and the top is ecstasy, and we can't jump up and down in one leap. Abraham says if you are depressed and apathetic, the biggest jump you can make is with anger. Why? Because anger is active and the other lower states are inert. I like to say, use anger as a booster rocket to propel you through the gravitational pull of the lower states. But once you're past that and freely moving, you must jettison that rocket as it will pull you off course. Get angry, use it wisely, and get to that place of peace. This is Jeannie King with TUG, True You Group. We are a worldwide online spiritual church group, and we invite you to join us every day and on Sundays. TrueYouGroup.com. Thank you.